Okay, so what we have set up here is another water test for the bees. This time we're doing things a little different, and this is probably going to be my last water test of the year. It's October 27th, and we're getting late in the season, and my bees are not doing a lot of foraging, but when we have a warm day like today, they are going out and they are still looking for nectar energy, and I do see a lot of pollen still coming in, so that's interesting. Recently, someone posted on one of my drinking water reviews and asked if bees like something like vitamin C in their water. And I responded to that saying that, first of all, I don't normally test that type of thing. I don't do additives to their water. What we're looking at is four containers that are 2:1 sugar water, 2 parts sugar, 1 part water. We know that they like that purified water. And we know that they prefer 50-50 sugar water, but this late in the season, we're giving them 2:1. Now, what is in these drinkers? Well, you'll notice that they are all labeled, and although the sugar water content is identical for all four, two of them are marked 1 teaspoon per quart. These are 1 quart entry feeders, and they have something called Honeybee Healthy in them. Honeybee Healthy is supposed to be a feed stimulant, and it has essential oils in it. It has sucrose, water, spearmint oil, lemongrass oil, and lecithin. And of course, on the bottle, it says that it's non-GMO lecithin. Well, you can see in this timeline sequence that my bees jumped all over the 2:1 sugar water that did not have the teaspoon of Honeybee Healthy in it. So, and I juxtaposed the positioning of these drinkers to make sure that they weren't all coming to the closest one on the end or taking care of variables like that. And as you can see through this time-lapse sequence, the bees really consumed regular sugar water first, and they saved the Honeybee Healthy mix for last. Now, there are a lot of claims regarding what Honeybee Healthy is supposed to do for your bees and your hive. It's supposed to stimulate them. Some people are supposed to use it to spray the hive when they're working on the bees so that it calms them down. There are a lot of claims about what it's supposed to do for them, but I suppose if you put out a drinker or an entry feeder and you had the teaspoon, the recommended teaspoon of Honeybee Healthy in with your sugar water, that the bees would appear to really go after that. Well, that's because you're not giving them any choices. So by looking at this board, they obviously demonstrated here, at least my bees, and these are northern bees. They come from the weaver family in Texas, and they're a survivor line honeybee, and they go after the non-additive sugar water first, and then they go after the Honeybee Healthy boosted water last. And there was a difference in which one they went for, as you can see here. The second one from the left was consumed first, and obviously the remaining Honeybee Healthy treated water is all the way to your right, and they use that last. And the duration of what you're watching here took place from noon until 4:30 p.m. and they consumed it all. Now, normally this time of year, I don't even feed my bees. I'm not feeding because they need resources in their hives. All of my hives are loaded right now. They're full of capped honey. They're basically ready for winter. Now, I will post in the description of the video the website for Honeybee Healthy. I'll also link where I purchased this on Amazon. I bought it. It wasn't given to me. When I review something, I buy it myself. And I just wanted to share with you what the results are here. And you can see it, it's pretty plain. Bees go after sugar water first, and then the Honeybee Healthy additive to the water last. So I hope you enjoy watching this. There is one more thing I'd like to mention about it, though, and that is that This honeybee healthy mixture really does have an appealing smell, and that is of course what is supposed to draw the bees to it or initiate or stimulate them to feed on whatever nectar you've put out. As we've already seen here, my bees will consume sugar water without any pheromone additive to get them interested in it. But there is a side effect that I might be a little worried about, and that is if they are feeding on sugar water that has honeybee healthy in it and that strong scent is with it. I'm just showing you the setup here that we used. I'm a little worried that that scent would be taken back to the hives, and then those bees that are searching for sugar water would get that scent and track it to a hive and smell it through the entry board, and of course challenge that beehive. A healthy hive of bees can of course defend their hive, but it's not the same when you're feeding just sugar water. Sugar water has no odor to it, and the bees would not track sugar water pheromone through the air very far. But this honeybee healthy stuff has a lot of ingredients in it that would be very easy for bees to locate based on smell. So I'm just showing you the label of the bottle here. This stuff goes for $29 on Amazon. A lot of the bee supply companies, Better Bee, Dadont, companies like that do sell this stuff, so you're welcome to look into it on your own. For me and my bees, I don't think I'll be using it. So thank you for watching. I hope you learned something and enjoyed my last drinking experiment of the season. Happy beekeeping.